brought to you by Crest. Crest, the toothpaste that's been clinically tested against cavities. The toothpaste for families that want fewer cavities. And now, let's all play What's My Line? And now, from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Probably the best-looking man in the world, Mr. Groucho Marx.
You don't like the hat.
It's me.
The next one is Mrs. Martin Gable of the Seven Little Gables.
We have a house at the Seven Little Gables.
Your husband will be proud of that.
And now a gentleman who has just returned from the Midwest, where he's been the life of the party.
Life of what party?
Our party.
Oh.
He's come back here now to be part of our party, Mr. Bennett, sir.
In Evansville, Indiana, the other day, a very observant lady at the old National Bank...
Is this going to be a long story, Bennett?
Very short. She told me that John Daly always looks down at his feet when he's introducing a contestant. I never noticed that. So watch with me tonight. Let's see if he does it tonight. Here he is, John Charles Daly.
Tonight, I'm not looking at my feet. I'm looking at that fine head of hair that Groucho's got over there. And I have a feeling that if I'm going to say anything serious at all tonight, I'd better get it said very quickly. And actually, it is serious, but it's...
I haven't heard a word you've said.
I know, that's fine,
Would you talk up, John?
I'll try to articulate better.
How's that? The larynx working.
Now, but let me be serious for a moment, Groucho. This is Diabetes Week, and I just want to say a very brief word. About 3.5 million people in this country have diabetes, and almost half of them don't know it. And that is a tragedy and very unnecessary. So call your doctor or the Diabetes Association or your medical society this week and ask for a test. It's a very simple thing to do, and it may help you a great deal. And now, Groucho, that's a lovely hat. You've been to Russia.
I tell you, I have a toupee, but it's faded and it's light blonde now, so I wore my wife's hat tonight.
Well, with Groucho here, anything can happen, so I decided we ought to make some of the things happen. Panel, I'm going to tell you right now, we're up to all kinds of tricks tonight, so get your masks ready because you're going to need them. We're going to have, for instance, two mystery guests tonight instead of one, and we'll have those two famous mystery guests before the panel almost immediately. Well, as previously announced, things are going to be a bit different tonight. We're going to have two mystery guests. The first one is going to appear in just a moment, as long as the panel can assure me that the blindfolds are in place. Are they, panel?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, then will our first mystery guest enter and sign in, please. All right. Panel, as you know, in the case of a mystery guest, we go to a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And you have here really a difficult road to follow. Certainly the line is important, but you are asked to identify our guest. And we'll begin everything with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Are you blindfolded because you may have met one of us?
Oh, our guest is not blindfolded, no.
Or are we? I'm sorry. Are we blind? Groucho's got me so confused. Are we blindfolded because we may have met you in person and know you?
Well, I think this is something that we would have every right to assume as a possibility. Yes, Dorothy.
Oh, so I keep going now?
No, Mr. Marks, you're next.
You want me to go?
Yeah, I want you to go. I mean, ask a question.
Oh. Well, is it a man or an animal?
It can't be answered yes or no.
I can't?
No.
Well, how am I going
to
find out?
You have to pick one or the other.
Okay, are you an animal?
No, that's one down and nine to go, Miss Preston.
That's good enough for me.
John, I've misunderstood, but on this first round, do we keep going as though we were playing the game without our masks, or are we playing it like the mystery guest?
We play it like the mystery guest. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise.
All right. Have you anything to do with the performing arts?
Well.
Has
dubious?
He said anything
yet?
Not yet.
Dubious.
Well.
Yeah, dubious. I would say no. That's two down and eight to go. I would say it's an issue that probably could be put in question, but as we would recognize the general area of activity, we would not say one of the performing arts. Mr. Sir.
I can't say anything.
I would like to ask a question that can count as my question. Are you answering for the mystery guest because the mystery guest cannot answer for him or herself?
No, not at all. It's just the questions have been so complex that they needed some explanation.
It seemed very
better.
Simple to me. You haven't had a word out of the mystery guest yet.
Well, you ask a question and we'll give you a word.
All right. Are you at all famous for some sporting activity?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
That's you, honey.
Yes, I know. I can think. Is this an outdoor sport?
Yes.
Mr. Marks?
Are you an outdoor sport?
We would have to agree, since he practices his particular skill outdoors, he's an outdoor sport. Yeah. Miss Francis?
It's up to you, babe.
Is it primarily a very popular American sport?
No, then it would be indoors.
No, that's great. Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Wait a minute. Did you just say no?
Yep, we said no.
It's not a popular sport, was that the
In America.
In America. Did you win any medals in the recent Olympic Games?
No.
That's four down and six
well,
to
why
go,
didn't
Ms. Kilgallen.
Can this sport be played by women, too?
Yes.
What a silly question.
Mr. Mark?
I feel silly.
Me?
Yeah.
Well,
It's your turn, baby.
Is there any specific country where they concentrate on this particular game? Like Paris or France?
Well, we will agree it's not Paris, France. That's five down and five to go, Miss France.
That wasn't an answer.
No, it certainly wasn't an answer.
You didn't answer that correctly.
But is there
any particular country?
Well, we will agree that there is a country in which there perhaps is a strong emphasis. Yes.
John, why don't you let him talk for himself?
Well, because I have to do all the explaining, you know, and...
He isn't saying anything.
Yeah, he did. He said yes or no a couple times there.
Does this sport involve animals?
I said that a while ago.
No, you asked if he was an animal.
That's your own question.
If it's good enough for you, it's good enough for me.
Yes, Mr. Sir?
Yes?
Yes.
Guess what?
Is the animal you cavort with a bull?
Yes.
Are you a bullfighter?
Yes.
Yup, now you've identified. Now let's see if any of you can name.
Oh!
Oh.
Oh. It isn't Cassius Clay, huh?
Think she knows. Let's pass to Arlene.
Well, I have just finished a book by Peter Vertel that is dedicated to Louis Dominguin. Is it the Louis
Yes,
Dominguin?
It is, Louis. Yes. Actually, this is what we thought might give us away. Mr. Vertel's book, Love Lies Bleeding, I think it's
named. Love Lies Bleeding, yes.
Which is this some... if you can't answer this, don't. But this is purported to be, really, in a sense, biographical, is it?
You might speak as slowly because I can understand few words in English.
Mr. Vertel's book.
Yes.
Is this a biography of you? It's purported to be.
No, Peter is a very good friend of mine, you know. He's coming with me. Many times I fight in my life. And I think he knows my life more than myself. Uh-huh. And I never read this book because I can't read English. But hope so. This book is in a few days is translated to Spanish. Uh-huh. And I am very interested because everybody says it's really wonderful.
Well, of course, another great writer, Ernest Hemingway, spoke of you, as you know. And,
John,
I'm sure you'll be very proud.
I just want to say, for the benefit of our audience that may not have been to Spain ever, that Luis?
Yes.
Luis Dominguín is one of the great bullfighters of Spain.
Could you do a little of it now?
Of all time.
You're throwing enough around
you
here to take care of
it. Well, thank you very much, Luis. It's nice to have you.
Bonus Natchez. Hasta luego.
And banana.
Ole.
Ole. All right, let's see what we can do in meeting a second challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please?
You mean there's going to be more people?
There could be more people. Jed. Jed Johnson, Jr., right? Mr. Johnson, will you tell us where you're from?
Chickasha, Oklahoma.
Chickasha, Oklahoma.
Chickasha.
All right, Mr. Johnson, may I present the panel? Do you have something to say about Chickasha, Mr. Mark?
I just say, I thought, you're not the colored prize fighter, Jack Johnson, huh?
No, that's not. That's the panel. Come with me. All right, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Johnson is salaried and deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Johnson, is this a service that any of us on the panel might use?
Yes.
When you are performing your service, do you work indoors?
Sometimes, yes.
Do people call you for your service?
Yes.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
One down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Johnson, do you work for some branch of government?
Yes.
Is it local rather than national?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Get one yes. Is it national?
Yes.
Do you ever wear a uniform?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Mark.
What kind of an outfit do you generally wear?
That can't be answered yes or no.
Nothing like that.
A wise guy. Well, is it, you work for nothing?
No.
You get paid?
Yes.
By the government?
Yes.
Is it, are you very high in the administration?
Now, this is a very general term. If you'd like to be specific as to the area of government, well, you know, you haven't yet...
Are you very high at night on Saturday?
No.
Well, then I give up.
Don't give up. You're doing fine.
Well, he won't tell me what business he's in. How sure is this? How much money do you get a year?
Can't answer that yes or no.
You can't answer that?
All questions have to be posed. Has to require no more than a yes or no answer.
Do you make a very large salary?
No. 4,060.
Unless you're doing a little moonlighting, Mr. Johnson.
Are you a supernumerary?
You just lost. That's 4,060 gold, Miss Francis.
I didn't say I'm sorry. That's part of my salary.
Yeah.
Do you, Mr. Johnson, have any title attached to your name?
Yes.
Is it a, do you have to have a degree in college for the work that you do?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Johnson, are you elected to your post?
Yes, I am.
Have you recently won in the November election?
Yes, I have.
Are you a new member of Congress from Ohio?
Yes, I am. Oklahoma.
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma. You're the fellow, you're the man who beat Bud Wilkinson?
No.
That's fine. We'll flip all the cards over, Bennett. You just did it because that wasn't the Senate. Now, this is really kind of fun because Mr. Johnson is a newly elected member of the House of Representatives. He is 24 years old. He becomes 25 on December 27, right? Okay. And on that date, reaches the legal age to assume the office to which he's been elected, the youngest man ever elected legally to the Congress. There was a gentleman named Mr. Claiborne.
Yes, Tennessee.
Mr. Claiborne from Tennessee, who back in the early days, in the 1800s.
1797.
Even before this, 1797, who was elected at age 22, I believe, and did serve, but it was a contravention of the Constitution. He shouldn't have. So this is the youngest man ever to be legally elected to the Congress of the United States. He won't be old enough to serve till December 27th, and he'll take off.
Congratulations.
I would like to say that the money that I'm going to find for the college.
Congressman Johnson has asked me to say that.
Can I ask another question?
Just one minute, please, Groucho. Congressman Johnson has asked me to say that the money that he has won by puzzling the panel substantially tonight is going to go to.
The Oklahoma College for Women Chapel Fund.
The Oklahoma College for Women Chapel Fund, because that's where his mom went to school, and that's where she wants it to go. That's right. There it will go. You wanted to ask a question, Groucho? You want to ask a question?
I just wanted to ask him, how much did your election cost you?
Don't ask that.
Too much.
Good. That's true. All right, and now
that's
we'll
what we need striplings in the Congress.
Striplings in the Congress. His name is Johnson. We'll meet our second mystery guest in just a moment. And now a second special feature on tonight's What's My Line, for which, again, the panel must be blindfolded. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Back on. Yes.
All right, will our second mystery challenger enter and sign in, please? Once again, panel, I must warn you that a different form of questioning is in order. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Bennett, sir.
Would your name feature prominently in the amusement sections of the newspaper? Oh, my God.
Miss Kilgallen?
Like a door closed.
Are you a curvaceous cutie?
This does not rule out. I will have to let the answer of our guest stand because I think very properly we are dealing here in broad terms of reference. Let me attest that the curves are there and very handsome, but I think curvaceous cutie might be a misnomer. Mr. Marks?
Are you referring to me?
With that head of hair?
Are you any specific sex?
Yes, Miss Francis?
That's good enough for me.
Sounds like Lassie. Are you at the present time, or are you just about to open in a new picture on Broadway?
Yes. Mr. Sir?
Have you ever played in The Unsinkable Molly Brown?
Never. Two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are you a blonde?
No. Three down and seven to go, Mr. Mark.
Have you ever played in Chickasha, Oklahoma? That was a big hit.
No. Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Have you just opened in... are you Julie Andrews?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Do you sing as part of your professional act?
No.
Six down and four to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Rather a reluctant no. Do you ever appear in musicals?
No!
Seven down and three to go, Mr. Mark.
Are you Sonny Liston?
Eight down and two to go, Miss Francis.
Are you also someone who has appeared in the theater as well as in pictures?
Yes! Mr. Sir?
Maybe it's Deborah.
Yeah. Are you married?
Yes!
Are you Deborah Carr?
No! Nine down and one to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, the obvious question is, are you married and not Deborah Carr? But that wouldn't do us much good, would it? I passed Mr. Marks. He'll at least have something funny to say.
Are you an old Buick?
No!
I'm pretty sick of her, whoever.
That is 10 down and no more to go.
The poor adult sitting here worrying about who she is.
Five. And Bancroft. 10 down and no more to go.
Terrible. I didn't want you to get me this time, Bennett.
Annie, how are you?
I'm very well, Groucho. How are you?
You've been eating too many pumpkins.
No, actually, we thought you'd get a pumpkin eater. I thought Arlene was on the road well. I think with a little more questioning, you might have gotten it, the pumpkin eater.
Never, never!
That voice was
I don't think it was quite fair to do that voice all the way, Annie.
Oh, that's right. I should have stopped it.
Yeah, no, once you should have given us a little help.
That's
you
my
have gotten
fault.
It.
We need
I
it.
Think we needed yeah. a little help, yeah.
What do you
I thought that was John answering all the time.
Well, why don't you go,
I bet the people in the
I'm waiting.
No, I bet
I have to do it graciously, Groucho.
I bet the people in the Midwest are glad Bennett's back home. What? Would you say,
I say, why doesn't she leave? We've
Well, you called her an old Buick. I'm trying to think of something or the other, you know, that'll
get
smooth.
Get somebody else in here now for a change.
Yeah, I know, but you called her an old Buick, and I'm trying desperately to think of something that'll smooth it over.
That's
old
all right. Buick. Groucho can call
Cadillac
me an old
will
Buick.
Do it.
Yeah, Cadillac.
John, can I say something to smooth it over? I think Miss Bancroft's one of the two or three greatest actresses in the country today.
Oh, couldn't
I
agree anymore. I don't like to embarrass her, but the...
what country were you referring to?
The Academy Award in 1963 for the miracle worker.
Yes, she did, and she recently got
was
married.
The most deserved ever given, as far as I'm concerned, by Hollywood. She was
and
a wonderful
adorable.
What did you say,
yes,
Mr. Monk?
A real cute guy she married.
She married a darling man.
I was terribly disappointed.
Is that his hat you have on today?
I never wear another man's hat. This
Can
is my
I
wife's
you?
Hat.
Ah, that's what I wanted to ask you. It is your wife.
It is
not
wife,
yours, because I thought if you were going to leave the theater that night, I'd call
woman.
The riot squad now and have them get here early.
Pretext, I could bring her out here and get $78.
You'd get $78. No, sorry, we don't have $78. We can't do that. Miss Anne, thanks very much
thanks.
For gracing our desk again,
thank
our
you.
Stage, and bless you and lots of success.
Thank
and
you.
See you again soon. Admit anything except that you've done rather well so far tonight, panel, and we'll all be back after this word. Good night, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Good night, 10022. Good night, Groucho. Good night.
Good night, no matter where you are.
Good night, 007.
Good night, dear Bennett.
Thank you, Ellie. Good night, John. I forgot to look whether you looked down tonight or not, did you?
I didn't. Things were too busy tonight. And good night, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for being with us on What's My Life.
Is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotton. This is Johnny Olson reminding you, if you'd like to attend one of our broadcasts, write to What's My Line, CBS Tickets, 485 Madison Avenue, New York, New York, 10022.
And almost half of them don't know it. And that is a tragedy and very unnecessary. So call your doctor or the Diabetes Association or your medical society this week and ask for a test. It's a very simple thing to do, and it may help you a great deal. And now, Groucho, that's a lovely hat. You've been to Russia.
I tell you, I have a toupee, but it's faded and it's light blonde now, so I wore my wife's hat tonight.
Well, with Groucho here, anything can happen, so I decided we ought to make some of the things happen. Panel, I'm going to tell you right now, we're up to all kinds of tricks tonight, so get your masks ready because you're going to need them. We're going to have, for instance, two mystery guests tonight instead of one. And we'll have those two famous mystery guests before the panel almost immediately. Well, as previously announced, things are going to be a bit different tonight. We're going to have two mystery guests. The first one is going to appear in just a moment, as long as the panel can assure me that the blindfolds are in place. They are they, panel?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, then will our first mystery guest enter and sign in, please. All right. Panel, as you know, in the case of a mystery guest, we go to a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And you have here really a difficult road to follow. Certainly the line is important, but you are asked to identify our guest, and we'll begin everything with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Are you blindfolded because you may have met one of us?
Oh, our guest is not blindfolded, no.
Or are we? I'm sorry. Are we blind? Groucho's got me so confused. Are we blindfolded because we may have met you in person and know you?
Well, I think this is something that we would have every right to assume as a possibility. Yes, Dorothy.
Oh, so I keep going now?
No. Mr. Marks, you're next.
You want me to go?
Yeah, I want you to go. I mean, ask a question.
Oh. Well, is it a man or an animal?
It can't be answered yes or no.
I can't?
No.
Well, how am I going
to
find out?
You have to pick one or the other.
Okay, are you an animal?
No, that's one down and nine to go, Miss Preston.
That's good enough for me.
John, I've misunderstood, but on this first round, do we keep going as though we were playing the game without our masks, or are we playing it like the mystery guest?
We play it like the mystery guest. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise.
All right. Have you anything to do with the performing arts?
Well.
Has
dubious?
He said anything yet?
Not yet.
Dubious.
Well.
Yeah, dubious. I would say no. That's two down and eight to go. I would say it's an issue that probably could be put in question, but as we would recognize the general area of activity, we would not say one of the performing arts. Mr. Sir.
I can't say anything.
I would like to ask a question that can count as my...
We have a house of the seven little guests.
Your husband will be proud of that.
And now a gentleman who has just returned from the Midwest, where he's been the life of the party.
The life of what party?
Our party.
Oh.
He's come back here now to be part of our party, Mr. Bennett, sir.
In Evansville, Indiana, the other day, a very observant lady at the old National Bank...
Is this going to be a long story, Bennett?
Very short. She told me that John Daly always looks down at his feet when he's introducing a contestant. I never noticed that. So watch with me tonight. Let's see if he does it tonight. Here he is, John Charles Daly.
Tonight, I'm not looking at my feet. I'm looking at that fine head of hair that Groucho's got over there. And I have a feeling that if I'm going to say anything serious at all tonight, I'd better get it said very quickly. And actually, it is serious, but it also it's...
You realize I haven't heard a word you've said.
I know, that's fine,
Would you talk up, John?
I'll try to articulate better. How's that?
The larynx working.
No, but let me be serious for a moment, Groucho. This is Diabetes Week, and I just want to say a very brief word. About 3.5 million people in this country have diabetes.
What? to you by Crest. Crest, the toothpaste that's been clinically tested against cavities. The toothpaste for families that want fewer cavities. And now, let's all play What's My Line? From New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
And now, probably the best-looking man in the world, Mr. Groucho Marx.
The next one is Mrs. Martin Gable of the Seven Little Gables.
I know already.
Question, are you answering for the mystery guest because the mystery guest cannot answer for him or herself?
No, not at all. It's just the questions have been so complex that they needed some explanation.
It seemed very simple to me. Yeah, we haven't had a word out of the mystery guest yet.
Well, you ask a question and we'll give you a word.
All right. Are you at all famous for some sporting activity?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
That's you, honey.
Yes, I know. If you can think, I can think. Is this an outdoor sport?
Yes. Mr. Marks?
Are you an outdoor sport?
We would have to agree, since he practices his particular skill outdoors, he's an outdoor sport. Yeah. Miss Francis?
It's up to you, babe.
Is it primarily a very popular American sport?
No, then it would be indoors.
No, that's great.
That's 3 down and 7 to go.
Mr. Sir.
Wait a minute. Did you just say no?
Yeah, we said no.
It's not a popular sport, was that the
year? In America.
In America. Did you win any medals in the recent Olympic Games?
No. That's 4 down and 6
well,
to go,
why didn't you?
Can this sport be played by women, too?
Yes.
What a silly question.
Mr. Marks?